Hello students, good morning to all. In today's session I would like to discuss about the last topic and new to you, that is rancidity and about corrosion. So first let me pick up you about rancidity. What is rancidity? Before I come to rancidity, I would like to discuss some of your daily phenomenon that you observe at your home. Suppose today, if you fried some chickens in oil and then kept for 2-3 days, then I think it will not feel tasty and the smell is also not good. The fresh one, it is tasty and smell is also good. Like that, if you fried your fish also, then after 2-3 days, their smell and their taste, and when you touch it, it is somewhat wet type, not dry. So all these conditions, how it happened? So this is happened due to oxidation. That means we are exposing our fats and oils containing food to air. So from air, the oxygen reacts with the fats and oils present in the food and make the smell and taste of the food changes, and sometimes it may be poisonous to us also. So this phenomenon is we term as rancidity. So rancidity, it is a very oftenly observed phenomenon to you all at your home. You eat your roasted or fried chicken or fish, and after 2-3 days you found it about bad smell and taste also not like the fresh one. This is a very common phenomenon to you all, and this has happened because we do not store them properly. Storing in proper way is also needed to avoid such conditions. So for definition of rancidity, you can look here. Rancidity is the process of oxidation of fats and oils present in food, changing the smell and taste of food. While writing your definitions about rancidity, you need to mention this last point. Many of the students skip this point. You just simply write oxidation of fats and oils present in food is rancidity. But the after effect, that means after oxidation, what happens to the food? You have to mention that. This is a very important point. So while writing your definition, you must always include this process of oxidation of fats and oils present in food, changing the smell and taste of food is called rancidity. So examples, I have cited you that after 2-3 days, your fried fish or meat, it will found smelly and taste not good. So these are all the examples of rancidity. Now students, here rancidity is not a desired phenomenon to us. It's undesirable phenomenon, so we want to prevent it because our food may spoil and it cause losses to us. So we want to prevent our food from rancidity. So what measures we should take up to prevent from rancidity? At home, we can do some simple methods to prevent from rancidity. So let me read out the methods or the measures to prevent rancidity. Number one, you can store your food in airtight container. And if in airtight container, if you store your food, then if air is not available, then oxidation process will slow down. Oxidation process will slow down. And then you can also use in your packaging foods. Many of your foods you buy in packets, they are oftenly mixed with antioxidants. using antioxidants while packaging. This is also one of the preventive measures. And then you can refrigerate your food. Refrigerating is also one of the preventive measures. Then again, very oftenly, you see that the chips, your potato chips and all, so that chips varieties in packets, when you see in packets, it has, you found that some gas is filled inside your packets. Your package is big, but it's not filled with chips. Some air is there. So that, not air, you will say that some gases is inside it. So we can flush some inert gases. Inert. Why I'm saying here inert? Inert means non-reactive, okay? Inert gases like nitrogen. Mainly we use nitrogen gases while packaging. So we will taken out all the air. That means we will do vacuum pumping. That means we will pump out all the air and flush. Instead of air, we will substitute by nitrogen gases. We will flush inside nitrogen gases in the chips packets so that oxidation not occurred. Slow down the process of oxidation. Some traces, some small amount of air oxygen may present, but it will take long time and your chips will last for 2-3 months. So these are some important preventive measures from rancidity: storing in airtight container, using antioxidants, refrigerating, then flushing inert gases like nitrogen while packaging. Again, students, we have another topic, a small topic about corrosion. What is corrosion? This is also your daily experience phenomenon to you all. You may found about your iron matte articles found rusted when you cap it in the open air, exposed in the air. And then again, some copper matte vessels or copper matte articles, if you expose in air, then you will found some green coating on the surface. And then silver matte articles also become tarnish. Means the silvery white of the article losses and becoming black, that we call tarnish. And this all phenomenons are also due to reactions between the surface of the metal. Copper, iron, silver, they are all metal. Surface of the metals, they react with its nearby surrounding, like air and moisture and acids, and then they reacts and changes into other product. So this phenomenon generally we call as corrosion. So by definition, you want to write definitions, then you can write definition as corrosion. When a metal surface is attacked by substances around it like moisture, air, acids, etc., it is said to corrode. It is said to corrode your metal or the articles made by metal is said to be corroded. And the process of corroding is called corrosion. That means the whole process is called corrosion. And for doing corrosion, you need moisture, air mainly, and the surface of the metals, surface mainly, it will start reacting from the surfaces, and that phenomenon is called corrosion. So very simple example, you will found rusting of iron, then black coating on silver and green coating on silver. These are some very common observed phenomenons or common examples of corrosion. And this corrosion is also an undesirable changes that we don't want, and we want to prevent this corrosion also. So to prevent this corrosion, you can do painting to avoid the contact of air and moisture, and then you can do galvanization of iron articles, and you can do alloying. Alloying means mixing of the two or more metals in the molten formed and then solidified again. And in this alloying process, the properties of the metal changes, and you can prevent the metals from corroding, from corrosion. That is this topic, corrosion topic, we will discuss in more detail in more broad in the chapter number 3, your metals and non-metals. So for in this first chapter, you just know that what is the process, what's the phenomenon. That is, it is also actually a chemical reaction. That means chemical reaction is going to happen to the metal surfaces while doing the phenomenon, while occurring this phenomenon, what we called as corrosion. So we will discuss again in more details and the different preventive measures of corrosion in chapter number 3. So up to this topic, that means with this topic, we end up our first chapter, chemical reactions and equations. And after I finish this chapter, I will give you some classwork assignments. That means you will maintain some question answers or some important notes in your notebooks. And then by time to time, I will also give you some important questions, yearly asked questions as your homework to be maintained in your, that means to be written in your homework copy. And then for small marks, I will keep on assessing you, like MCQ questions or like two questions, not a very, it will not a burden to you. So that you can keep in contact with your topics, with your chapters, keep on memorizing. I think my all good students are doing well. And if you have any doubt, don't hesitate, just ask me. And in your chemistry day, chemistry classes day, I will be also available from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. for your to pick up your calls of any query. And with this, I would like to thank you all for watching my videos, all the videos of this chapter 1, related videos of the chapter 1. And if you want to revise it, watch again and again the videos, and have any query, ask me. And with this, I wind up today's session. Thank you.